Hello children, how are you all? Welcome to Electronic Chemistry Center. This is VKM and welcome to the class of Mole Concept and Stoichiometry. Mole Concept and Stoichiometry. As we know, we are discussing this Mole Concept and Stoichiometry since 1 week. Almost 8 sessions are over, I think so. Right? I'm not sure about the number, don't worry. Right? So now, almost we came to an end. And a very important part we are going to discuss in today's session also. So far we have discussed about limiting reagent calculations as well as stoichiometric calculations we have done. But when we are doing practical inorganic chemistry, when we are performing the practicals, you require even few concentration terms. And those concentration terms will be useful to perform, you know, practical experiment calculations. So in practicals, okay, if you want to calculate or if you want to find the amount of substance, you should know the few terms or few methods of expressing concentration. So understood here? Now, concentration of a solution or the amount of substance present in a given volume of the solution can be expressed in any of the following ways. See here, solute is present in solvent. Solute when you dissolve in solvent. So, solute plus solvent gives you solution. Solute plus solvent gives you solution. Now, if you want to find out that amount of solute which is present in a given amount of solution, that is known as concentration. So simply, how much amount of solute is there in a given amount of solution, is known as concentration, and that concentration can be find it out by the help of various concentration terms. Number one, we have mass percent or weight percent or mass percentage. You can say mass percentage also. Mass percentage. Similarly, volume percent or volume percentage. You can write it as V by V percentage. Mole fraction, which is indicated by the symbol chi. Molarity indicated by the symbol capital letter M. Molality L indicated by the symbol small letter M. Normality indicated by the symbol N. Understood? So here molarity, mole fraction, molality, and mass percent and volume percent. These five we have actually, right? These five we have actually for, you know, board exams. Normality is there for the competitor, but in the first year or in the class 11, we do not have it. Don't worry. It is there in the second year, but we will learn it for the competitive purpose. Understood? So these are the six concentration terms we are going to discuss. Understood? Term we have is mass percent or mass percentage. These are very simple, you know, concentration terms. We will discuss it rapidly, not an issue. Mass percentage is nothing but the amount of solute present in a given mass of solution, right? How much amount of solute is present in a given mass of solution can be taken it as mass percentage. So that mass percentage is equal to mass of solute upon mass of solution into 100. I can write the same as mass percentage is W by W percentage, weight of solute small letter W, weight of solution small letter W plus capital letter W into 100. This is the formula can be given, right? So small letter W indicates for weight of a solute. This is weight of solute, right? Small letter W, weight of solute, capital letter W, weight of solvent. Together gives you weight of solution. That is the formula can be given for mass percentage. Similarly, volume percentage. Volume percentage, V by V percentage is nothing but small letter V upon V plus V into 100. Small letter V represents the volume of solute, capital letter V represents the volume of the solvent. Together it is called as volume of solution. So here volume of solution are mass of solution in the sense volume of solute plus solvent and mass of solute and solvent respectively. So how much volume of solute is present in a given volume of solution is known as volume percentage. See here, the amount of solute, amount of solute present in 100 grams of solution is known as a mass percentage, is known as a mass percentage. So here volume of solute present in 100 ml of solution, 100 ml of solution is known as a volume percentage, is known as a volume percentage. So these are the first two concentration terms we have. Next, if you observe, there is a small, easy numerical. A solution is prepared by adding 2 gram of a substance A, 18 gram of water. The substance which is present in lesser amounts is always to be taken as a solute. 2 grams means it is the mass of solute. Mass of a solute, less amounts, no? Larger amounts, if it is present, that is solvent. So, mass of a solvent is 18 grams. Understood? Calculate the mass percentage of the solute. Mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Most of the people, they used to commonly do the mistake like 2 by 18 into 100, they'll keep it. That is wrong, children. So, in denominator, if you observe it, that is mass of solution. It is a sum of mass of solute and solvent. So, 2 plus 18 should be taken. Okay? So, that will give you final answer 10%. Mass of solute is 2 gram divided by solution 2 plus 18, 20 into 100. 10% is the mass percentage. 10% is the mass percentage. Understood? The similar way, you can do it for volume percentage also, but they will give it in ml. Next concentration term we have, that is mole fraction. Name indicates very clearly. For suppose, there are two friends. And A and it is B. One friend name is A and another friend name is B. So you are going to share the chocolates. Like, okay, there are 10 chocolates. There are how many chocolates? 10 chocolates. A got, 6 chocolates and B got 4 chocolates. Right? So, what is the fraction of the B? That I can take it as 4 by 10. What is the fraction of the A? 6 by 10. Why? Because out of 10, A got 6 chocolates. Out of 10, B got 4 chocolates. That's a 4 by 10. For A, it is a 6 by 10. Understood? So, similarly, in a solution, if you consider, there are 2 components. In a solution, there are how many components? 2 components. One component is solute. Another component is solvent. That you know. Now, here, solute got how many moles and solvent got how many moles can be expressed in mole fraction. Means number of moles of solute. Okay, in the total number of moles of solution. That is the mole fraction of the solute. Similarly, number of moles of solvent in the total number of moles of solution, right? That is the mole fraction of the solvent. So, I can give the definition. What is mole fraction? It is the ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of all the components in the solution. Okay? If the substance A and B, their number of moles are Na and Nb respectively, and the mole fractions of A and B can be given as. How do you give the mole fraction of A and B? Number of moles of A upon number of moles of solution. Solution means solute plus solvent. Anything you can consider as solute and solvent, either A or B, that is depends on you. A, if it is A is solute, B is solvent and vice versa. So, number of moles of A is Na divided by number of moles of solution is Na plus Nb. So, mole fraction of A is nothing but it is the ratio of number of moles of component. Here, what is the component? Solute, let us say, or A, to the total number of moles of solution. That is in turn equal to Na upon Na plus Nb. Hope you understand. Similarly, you can give mole fraction of B, right? Mole fraction of B, that is number of moles of B upon number of moles of solution. So, if I write that mole fraction is chi A is equal to Na upon Na plus Nb. This is for solute. Chi B is equal to NB upon NA plus NB. It is a ratio, no? It is a ratio of number of moles of component to the total number of moles of solution. So, as it is ratio, it has no units. Mole fraction does not have any units, children. And if you observe that, so chi A plus chi B, sum I have taken, okay, addition of the mole fraction of the two components, that I can take it as Na upon Na plus Nb plus Nb upon Na plus Nb. So it gives you, take LCM and Na plus Nb, you will get it. So which is in turn equal to 1. So here, how many components are there? Two components are there, A and B. Similarly, though how many components are present in a solution, sum of mole fraction of all components is always equal to 1. Understood? It is equal to unity or equal to 1. Okay? If they ask you to find it out sometimes, mole percent. That mole percent can be given it as mole fraction into 100. Percent is, so that's why multiplied with 100. Mole fraction into 100. This is the formula. See here, physical chemistry always involves calculations. Always involves calculations. So that's the reason you have to remember the formula carefully. So if you know the formula, you can substitute the data easily. You can substitute the data easily and you'll get the answer. I'm giving a question. Sum of the mole fractions of all the components always. All the components always. They have given four options. Timer started. 20 seconds time I have given. Answer it first. Sum of the mole fractions of all the components always. Please post it in the live chat. Post it in the live chat, children. Please post it in the live chat. Time up. So the answer is 1. Sum of the mole fraction of all the components always equal to 1. Clear? Which of the following are true statements? Which of the following are true statements? So true statements. Sum of mole fraction of all the components equal to 1. Mole fraction is independent of temperature. Of course, there is no volume term involved here. Whenever volume term involved, obviously depends on temperature. Volume term involved, it depends on the temperature. But here there is no involvement of volume term, so it is independent of temperature. Mole fraction is one method of expressing concentration. Yes, so all the statements are correct. All the statements are correct. The very important concentration term we are going to discuss, that is molarity. It is the best concentration term. Molarity and normality, both these are the best concentration terms which are used to express the concentration. Which are used to express the concentration, children. So it is the most widely used concentration term and it is denoted by capital letter M. Molarity is denoted by the capital letter M. Understood? Right? So molarity is denoted by the capital letter M. It is defined as number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of the solution. Present in 1 liter of the solution. Hope you understand. Is it clear? So what does it mean? For suppose if I take V liter of the solution. V liters of solution I have taken. If V liters of solution consisting of N moles of solute and 1 liter of solution, 1 liter of solution consisting of how many moles, right? Do the cross multiplication. 1 into N divided by V, which is equal to N by V, that only can be taken as molarity. Okay, that only can be taken it as molarity. So, molarity is nothing but number of moles of solute, that is small letter n, upon volume of solution in liter. Okay. So, how many moles of solute is present in 1 liter of the solution can be taken as molarity. Okay. For suppose, if A grams of the solute is present in V ml of the solution, A grams means mass of the solute they have given, in VML of the solution, then how do you take it? Molarity of the solution can be taken it as, that is a formula, and the terms also expressed it very clearly. So I'll give the detailed explanation. M is equal to N upon V. But number of moles, you know the formula, given mass upon molar mass. Given mass upon molar mass. See children, there is a different way of expressing the same words by different teachers. Like they'll say mass of solute by molar mass. And few will say weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute. Few people will say like that. Okay. So I always used to say that mass upon molar mass into 1 by V, your volume of solution is in liter. For suppose if I want to express that in milliliter, then mass of solute or given mass, mass of solute by molar mass, mass of solute by molar mass into 1000 by V. Your volume is in milliliter. Your volume is in milliliter. So this is the formula they have given at ESC. Mass of solute, they took it as A or weight of solute. X is the molar mass of the solute or molecular weight of the solute or gram molecular weight, GMW, anything, into 1000 by V. These are the two formulas we will use it for, molarity. We will use it for molarity. Understood the point, children? Is it clear for you? So molarity is equal to N by V. In the numerator, what we have? Mole. In the denominator, what we have? Liter. So what are the units can be taken for molarity? Mole per liter. Mole per liter, or I can take it as mole liter inverse. Mole liter inverse. And most of the time, so if I express it as M, M stands for molar. M stands for molar. Like they will say 1M solution. Means what does it mean? 1 molar solution. If they say decimolar solution. If they say decimolar solution. Means 0.1 molar solution. Understood? If they say centimolar solution. Centimolar solution. 10 raised to minus 2 molar. Understood? So this is the way how they, will give it in the different numericals. Understood the point, children? Okay. Now, based on molarity also, we have different formulae. Based on the molarity also, we have different formulae. And these formulae are very, very important for the competitive examination, children. These formulae are very important for competitive examination. Understood the point? Let's discuss about those formulae. First formulae, these are the different formulae. I'll explain everything, you don't worry. Okay, so the first formula, if you observe it, molarity. Okay, I'll give that explanation. First formula, then I'll talk about this. Molarity is equal to 10 into weight by volume percentage of the solution by gram molecular weight. This is the formula they have given. See, weight by volume percentage means what is the formula? Weight of solute divided by volume of solution into 100. Yes or no? Okay. Then weight of solute by volume of solution into 100. So it is the formula can be given for the weight by volume percentage. Can be given for the weight by volume percentage. Now, what is the formula I have it for molarity? Molarity is equal to mass upon mass of solute upon molar mass into 1000 by V. Do you agree with it? Okay. And multiply and divide with 100. Multiply and divide with 100. Observe it carefully. Molarity is equal to mass of solute, weight of solute, volume of solution into 100. This term I can replace it as weight by volume percentage. Yes or no? Cancel it. What do you have? 10 divided by what we have? Molar mass. Check it. Or gram molecular weight. This is the formula what we got it now here. Check it. So it is the relation between molarity and weight by volume percentage of the solution. It is the relation between weight by volume percentage and molarity. Understood? So please, hope you understood means, okay, you can take the screens out of it. It's very important. But nobody asks you to derive the, you know, the relation in competitive examinations. No, but they will ask you, actually you have to remember the formula. Based on the formula, they will ask you to do the calculations for a particular numerical. Understood, ma? Right? So let's see the second one. Let's see the second one. Second one, what they have given. See, M is equal to 10 into density of solution into W upon W, weight by weight percentage of solution, upon gram molecular weight. Upon gram molecular weight. Children, as you know, density of solution is equal to mass upon volume. Now, mass of solution can be taken as a density into volume. Will you agree with me? Very simple, no? Yes or no, children? But we have mass percentage. We have mass percentage. Mass percentage means W by W percentage. What is the formula? What is the formula W by W in the sense? You tell me, what is the formula we have for weight by weight percentage? That is mass of solute. You can write weight of solute also, not an issue. Upon mass of solution into 100. Yes or no? Okay, into 100 means mass of solution we have, no? So W by W percentage is equal to mass of solute divided by into 100 is there. Mass of solution I can write it as D into V. D into V I can write it, no? Density into volume. And mass of solute is equal to D into V into weight by weight percentage, okay, divided by 100. Check it there. Okay. Now, molarity. What is the formula? Mass of solute divided by molar mass or gram molecular weight into 1000 by V. Mass of solute, I can substitute this formula D into V into W by W percentage into 1000 upon gram molecular weight into V into 100. Check it. So V gets cancelled. 10 will be remained. So what we got it finally, 10 into this one. Density of solution into weight by weight percentage upon gram molecular weight. That is what we got it here. Check it carefully. If you understood, okay, say yes. Right? So this is the relation between molarity and density and weight by weight percentage. Whenever density of solution and weight by weight percentage of a solution upon gram molecular weight, whenever density of solutions or weight percentage of solution is given, this is the relation you have to use it. Hope you understand. Take the screenshot. I'll wait. Hope you have copied it. Yes. Now I'll erase this. Let's see the another relation. Okay. Another relation what we have. It's another very important. That is dilution law. What we have? That dilution law. So what is nothing? What is meant by, sorry, what is meant by dilution? Addition of water. Adding water is called dilution, right? Adding water is nothing but dilution. I took a, you know, beaker. I have taken a solute. So now, number of moles of solute, I am taking it as N1. Before adding water or before diluting, simply I can say before dilution, okay, and whose volume of the solution, let us say V1, and whose molarity will be M1. Yes or no? Now what I have done, I have added water. I have added water. That means I have done dilution. I have done dilution in the sense, after dilution, let us say volume has become V2, molarity has become M2, and number of moles has become N2. Yes or no? But there is a change in volume. Obviously, upon adding water, there is a change in volume. And as well as there is a change in concentration, M2 also. Molarity changes, concentration changes. And what about N2? Number of moles is changes. Why? Because number of moles of solute is dissolved in 1 liter of the solution. Right? So now, if upon adding water, number of moles of solute will be same. There is no change in the number of moles of solute. Means N1 will be equal to N2. So before dilution, how many moles are there? Same moles of solute will be there even after dilution. But as you know the formula, M is equal to N by V. So N is equal to MV. That means N1 will be equal to M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. So this is nothing but dilution law. M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. Before dilution, how many moles are there? Same moles will be there even after dilution. Understood? Same moles will be there. According to dilution law, M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. According to dilution law, M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. Hope you understand, children. So it is another formula. Okay. Now, in neutralization, especially for acid-based titrations, we will use this formula. M1 V1 upon N1 is equal to M2 V2 upon N2. Same way, like if I take it, you know, A plus B giving rise to C plus D. N1 moles of A and N2 moles of B. Right? Sorry, stoichiometric coefficient is N1 and stoichiometric coefficient is N2 here. Right? That may be any stoichiometric coefficient like 2, 3 like that. Okay? And here some stoichiometric coefficient I have taken, that is N1 moles of A is reacting with N2 moles of B. But in acid-based titrations, what we will take it, M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. But similarly, that number of moles should be divided by the stoichiometric coefficient. Should be divided by the stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, in acid-based titration. Now, molarity of mixture of two solutions. I have taken solution 1 as well as solution 2. And both these solutions are of having different concentrations and different volumes. I have mixed these solutions. Solution 1, solution 2, I have mixed. Solution 1 and solution 2, I have mixed it. Now, what happens to the resultant concentration? What happens to the resultant concentration? That I can resultant concentration or final concentration. In another way, resultant or final concentration. So, final concentration, resultant concentration will be molarity mixture into volume of the mixture will be equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Both we have added, no? Right? That's why molarity of the mixture is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2 upon volume of the mixture. I can take it as V1 plus V2. This is the formula. Molarity of the mixture or resultant mixture concentration at final concentration. This is the formula can be given. Understood? This is all data about molarity. It's all the data about molarity. Very important concept, children. Okay? Now, let's see that few small examples. Very easy examples. Calculate the molarity of NaOH in the solution prepared by dissolving 4 grams enough water to form 250 ml of the solution. Molarity, what is the formula? Mass of solute divided by molar mass into 1000 by V. Simply, what is the mass of solute? 4. Molar mass of NaOH is 40 into 1000 by volume is 250. 4 by 10, that is 0.4 molar is the answer. Understood? And the most important point here, the molarity of a solution always depends on temperature. Why? M is equal to N upon V. There is a volume term. Okay, there is a volume term in denominator, right? So volume is depends on temperature. So if temperature changes, volume changes. If volume changes, molarity also changes. Understood the point? Okay. Next. Next concentration term, what we have? Molality. What is the next concentration term? Molality indicated by the letter small letter M. Excuse me, small letter M. It is defined as number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. So in 1 kg of solvent are 1000 grams of solvent. How many moles are there? That can be expressed as molality. That can be expressed as molality. It is denoted by small letter M. Formula, number of moles of solute by mass of solvent in kg. Mass of solvent in kg. So number of moles, if you observe it, what is the formula? Weight by gram molecular weight. This is the formula. Or mass by molar mass, whatever you can say. Into 1 by mass of solvent in kg. 1 upon mass of solvent in kg. Or 1000 by mass of solvent in grams. In grams means 1000 by mass of solvent. And in kg means 1 upon mass of solvent. Simply molality small letter M. Mass upon gram molecular weight. It is mass of solute. Into 1 by W. It is weight of solvent. Our same formula. Into 1000 by W. 1000 by W. Here it is in grams. Here it is in kg. Understood? This is the way how to express the molality. Okay. So if you observe that, an example, it will give a better picture. So molality units, what are the units of molality? Mole per kg. Number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. No? Or I can take it as mole into kg inverse. Mole into kg inverse. It is another formula, I can take it. Understood? So there is a question. What is the molality of the solution containing 60 grams of glucose? Molecular weight also given in 100 ml of water. 100 ml of water. So what you will take it here? So density of water, as you know, 1 gram per 1 ml. Means 1 ml is equal to 1 gram. 100 ml is equal to 100 gram. 100 ml is equal to, understood? 100 ml is equal to 100 gram. So here, they gave us weight of solvent as 100 grams. So 60 upon 180, mass of solute is 60, molecular weight is 180, 1000 upon 100. So which gives you 3.33 m. 3.33 m. That is 3.33 molal. What do you say? 3.33 molal. 3.33 molal solution means 3.33 moles of solute. Moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. 1 kg of solvent. Understood? Another important concentration term we have, that is normality. What is the concentration term we have? Normality, which is indicated by the symbol capital letter N. There is a small concept, I'll get back to it. If you observe here, molality is independent of temperature. Molality is independent of temperature. Why? There is no volume term. But whereas molarity depends on temperature, but molality is independent of temperature. Understood? Normality, if you observe it. Normality is number of gram equivalents. See, whenever there are two concepts, whenever if you use mole concept, we can use a concentration term molarity. But whenever if you use equivalent concept, more finer, equivalent concept, then it is normality. Then we will use a concentration term normality. So, for in molarity, number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of the solution. But here, in normality, equivalent concept, no, number of equivalents, gram equivalents of the solute present in the 1 liter of the solution. It is indicated by N. Instead of number of moles, we will take number of gram equivalents. That is the only difference. Number of gram equivalents. So, capital letter N is equal to number of gram equivalents of the solute upon volume of the solution liter, that is V. Okay. So, number of gram equivalents, which is in turn equal to weight upon gram equivalent weight. Earlier, what you had written for number of moles, weight upon gram molecular weight. But here, what you will write it, weight upon gram equivalent weight. That is the only difference. Weight upon gram equivalent weight. So, normality is equal to weight upon gram equivalent weight into 1000 by V. Into 1000 by V. They have expressed terms also. Similarly, I can write normality is equal to weight upon gram equivalent weight into 1 by V, where volume is in liters. Where volume is in liters. It is also another formula can be given. Understood? So, weight, small letter W is weight of solute. Capital letter W, that is actually not capital letter, weight of solute in grams. V is volume of solution. V is the volume of the solution in ml. Now, there is a concept I am going to explain in detail. Relation between molarity and normality, I am going to talk about it. Relation between molarity and normality. What is the formula of normality? Normality is nothing but weight of solute upon gram equivalent weight into 1000 by V. Then weight upon gram equivalent weight. Equivalent weight formula we are discussing lecture 6 and lecture 7. I think so. Lecture 5 and 6. Gram equivalent weight, what is the formula? Gram molecular weight upon valency. That valency I can indicate as N into 1000 by V. Volume is in ml. The same thing I can write it as weight into 1000 upon gram molecular weight into V, valency factor N, that I am, so you know, I am actually sending it to the numerator part. Right, children? So, it is normality formula. So, normality is equal to weight into 1000 by gram molecular weight into, weight into 1000 by gram molecular weight into volume. This term I can replace it as molarity. So, normality is equal to molarity into N factor. In a symbolic form, N is equal to capital letter M into small letter N. Capital letter M into small letter N. Understood? So, this N factor may be basicity for an acid. May be basicity for an acid. Okay. Acidity for a base. Acidity for a base. It depends. The N factor, it might be anything. Okay. It depends on the substance what we are going to take it. Hope you understood the relation. How we have derived it also, hope you understood. Is it clear for you or not? Yes or no? Say yes or no. Then we will go for solving multiple choice questions. MCQs, multiple choice questions. The first question, it's very, very simple. Just, you know, basic questions. Molarity is indicated by capital letter M. What is the unit of molality? L. What is the unit of molality? Obviously, mole per kg. Which of the following is correct statement? Which of the following is a correct statement? Right? So, if you observe that, which of the following is correct statement? So, all these are the correct statements. Why? Because molarity depends on temperature. Mole fraction is also independent of temperature. M is equal to N by V. And all statements are correct. Okay? Let's see the numericals. So far we have discussed about so many concentration terms, right? About so many concentration terms we have discussed. Now we will be solving a few numericals. Okay, let's try to solve this first numerical. What is the normality of the solution? What is the normality of the solution containing 4 gram of NaOH in 250 ml of water? Okay, so normality, what is the formula? Weight by gram equivalent weight into 1000 by 250. What is the weight of NaOH? 4 gram. Gram equivalent weight, that is nothing but atomic weight or molecular weight, sorry, molecular weight by basicity, sorry, base, no, acidity. Molecular weight to 40, acidity 1, so 40 by 1 is equal to 40. Understood? So into 1000 by 250, which gives you 0.4 equivalent per liter. Okay, 0.4 N. Normality units, if you observe it, that is gram equivalent per liter. What are the units of normality? Gram equivalent per liter. Hope you understand. Here onwards, some of our good questions. 9.8 grams of H2SO4 is present in 2 liters of a solution. The molarity of the solution. Molarity, what is the formula we have? Molarity formula, weight of solute into, sorry, weight of solute upon molecular weight of solute into 1 by V. Volume is in liter, no, that's why. Weight of solute is how much? 9.8. Molecular weight of H2SO4, 98 into 1 by 2, which gives you 0.05 molar. Which gives you 0.05 molar. Understood the point? Is it clear for you? Right? So option B is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. Second question, it is based on normality. If 1.26 grams of oxalic acid is dissolved in 250 ml of solution, then its normality is. Oxalic acid formula, H2C2O4.2H2O. That is oxalic acid dihydrate. Oxalic acid dihydrate, children. So weight of solute is how much? 1.26. Weight of solute is how much? 1.26. Oxalic acid, it's a dibasic acid. It is a dibasic acid. So equivalent weight can be taken as molecular weight by 2. 126 upon 2. That will give you 63. That 63 I have substituted here into 1000 by 250. Which gives you 0.08 normal. So option D is the correct answer. Understood? Is it clear for you? Right. And third one. Molarity of 0.6 normal phosphorus acid. 0.6 normal phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid formula H3PO3. We had discussed about this basicity also. Basicity is equal to 2. Normality is 0.6, molarity we have to calculate it into basicity will be 2, molarity is equal to 0.3 molar. These type of questions are very important for CET level, children. Very important for CET level. In CET level, they will ask these type of questions. Molarity of 0.6 normal phosphorus acid. Option A is the correct answer, 0.3 molar. Understood? Fourth question. Volume of water, these are important for NEET as well as for JEE mains. These type of questions are important for NEET as well as JEE mains. Volume of water to be added to 400 ml of N by 8 HCl to make it exactly N by 12. Means I am changing the concentration and volume of water to be added to 400 ml. That means I am diluting. I am diluting it, so I have to follow dilution law. For molarity as well as for normality, same. N1 V1 is equal to N2 V2. N1 is equal to how much? 400 ml. Sorry, V1 is equal to 400 ml. N1 is 1 by 8. N by 8 is equal to 1 by 12 concentration. Volume we don't know. And this is the volume we are going to get it. 600 ml. Right? But volume of water to be added. How much? V2 minus V1 you have to take it. Don't take this answer directly 600 ml. Most of the time, okay, that V2 value will be given in the answer, right? So most of the students, they used to take the 600 ml as an answer, but V2 we have calculated, no? This is the final volume. This is the final volume upon adding water. 400 has become 600. For initial, how much ml is there? 400. So 400 has become 600. Means how much amount of water you have added? 600 minus 400, which gives you 200 ml. So Option C is the correct answer. Understood? Fifth question. Molality they are asking. 3 grams of salt, mass of solute of molecular weight 30 is dissolved in 250 grams of water. Weight of the solvent. Weight of solute is how much? 3. Molecular weight is 30 into 1000 by 250. Weight of the solvent in grams. Which gives you 0.4 m. Small letter m. Molal. So, answer A is the correct answer for this. Understood? Very simple. Very simple it is. Okay. Sixth. If we take 44 grams of CO2, 14 grams of N2, what will be the mole fraction of CO2? Two gases they have taken. One is CO2, another one is N2. First, find out the number of moles of CO2. Mass by molar mass. What is the mass? 44. Given. Given mass is 44. Molecular weight of CO2 also 44, which gives you 1. Number of moles of N2. Number of moles of N2. Weight of N2 by molecular weight of N2. Right? Weight of N2 is how much? 14 gram. Molecular weight of N2 is how much? 28, which gives you 0.5. N is equal to number of moles of CO2 plus number of moles of N2, which is 1 plus 0.5. Understood? So, total number of moles are 1.5. I have to calculate the mole fraction of CO2. Number of moles of CO2 upon total number of moles. 0.5 upon 1.5. That is 1 by 3. 1 by 3 means, okay, what is the answer? That you can see it in the previous slide. That is option B is the correct answer for it. Option B is the correct answer for this. Understood the point, children? Answer B is the correct answer. Okay. So, this is all about today's session. Almost we have covered basic numericals. We have covered as well as concentration terms like molarity, normality, weight percentage, volume percentage, molality, mole fraction also we have covered. So, immediately you revise NCERT and solve some questions in textual or, you know, exercise questions also. Then, it will give you a better idea. Hope you understand, children. Is it clear for you? Okay. Hope you like the video. If you like it, please click on the like button. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. And if you have already subscribed, please click on the bell icon for further notifications and videos. Okay. If you have any doubts, don't hesitate to post it in the comment box. Okay. So please post it in the comment box. I'll be immediately responding to your doubts. Until then, signing off. Take care.